When you first set up a WordPress website, this is typically what happens on your WordPress website. See it on screen right here. The home page of the website becomes a blog feed. What that means is that all the blog posts that you publish are just started to list down on the home page of the website. Now, depending on what you're trying to do with your website, you might like this or you might not like this. And if you don't like this, you've landed on the right video. Because in this video, I'm going to show you exactly how to change this behavior in WordPress, how to set up a different blog post or a page typically to have all the blog posts listed on the site, or you can create a blog feed separately on a different page on a site. And this will also result in having or you having a static home page of your website. Now, there are a few different ways to achieve this, so I suggest that you watch the video till the end, because I'm going to start with the basic and the most easiest method, and then going into a little more, I'd say, not the complex method, but a method that gives you more control over what blog posts you want to show on your website and how you want to show them. So even if you don't just want to set up a simple blog post, there's a lot of value in watching the video till the end. All right, let's get started with method number one, the easiest way to set up a different blog post or page where it lists all the blog posts on your site. Let's go. So I'm logged into the admin area of my website, and let me show you the quickest way how you can create a different page which just shows off your blog post on your website. The first step you need to do is to create a separate page which will just act as the blog page or blog feed for your site. If I go to my pages right now, you'll see I already have created a page which is just blog, and it's an empty page right now. There's no content there. And you can just name it anything. You can call it a blog feed or a blog post or anything like that. The name or the nomenclature of the post or nomenclature of the page doesn't really matter. All is important is you have to have a page which will serve as the blog for your site. Once you've done that, go to WordPress settings right here. Go to reading settings right here. And once you're in the reading setting, this is the most important setting you should be focusing on. Your homepage displays, and this is the setting you'll be changing, the most important setting. Right now, set to your latest post. That means all the posts on my site are being listed, which I showed you off in the demonstration as well. What we'll do is change this behavior by clicking this option right here, which will open up these two options as well. And this will give us an option of selecting a different page for just the homepage of the site and selecting a different page for all the posts on your site. So right now, the homepage of the site, I'll select the home page. This will create the homepage as a static page on my website, which I can design using any of the editors, the blog editor or any page builder. And this is the most important step, posts page, which is the page on the site which you want to assign as the blog post right now, or just showing off all the blog posts. And of course, as I demonstrated, as I mentioned, I have created the blog page specifically for this purpose. So I'll select it right now. Then you have a couple of simpler options, blog posts, show at least, or how many posts. So I've set it to 20. You can configure it to anything you like. Syndication feed 20 is like. For each post in the feed, include excerpt or full text. I would recommend if you're using this page for marketing or this page is important, an excerpt is usually fine because the entire or blog post is not shown, which might take a lot of space and it makes it difficult for you to scroll or the visitors to scroll through all the content on your site. And once you've done, just save your changes right now. And I'll go back to this page, which is still the home page. I haven't refreshed the page. Let's change this. And right now you'll see the home page is completely blank because now I haven't designed the home page at all. And this just becomes a new page on my site, which is just a static home page. And if I go back to my settings right here, let's go to the pages once again. You'll see something interesting. Now WordPress is highlighting that what page is the home page and what page is the blog post page. So home is now the front page of my website, and the blog page is the post page on my site. And if I open this up in a new tab right here, you'll notice now the blog post page is showing off all the different posts on my website, while the home page is just completely blank. So now you've separated both of these pages. The home page can be designed completely, so you can completely design the page for any kind of marketing purpose or showing off what you do. And the blog page can be just a culmination of all the blog posts that you publish on the site. So this was the first method, the easiest way to set up a different page on your site, which will list all the blog posts on your site. Easy peasy, works really well. But what about a scenario where you want to show off the blog posts from a certain category on your website, right? Only a select number of posts on your site. How do you achieve that? Let's also talk about that. So once again, I'm going to go to the admin area of my website. And of course, the prerequisite for this method is that you should have already assigned different categories to your blog posts already. For example, if I go to the post right here, you'll see all my posts are in different categories. I've just named them very innovatively, cat 1, cat 2, cat 3, and cat 4. And different posts, the random posts on my website, have been assigned to different categories. Now, if I want to create a different page just to highlight the post from just one of those categories, it's actually very simple. Go to the category section right here. And of course, your categories will already be created right here, right? So just hover over the category, just click the view button and open in a new tab. And you'll see a link right here automatically being created by WordPress. And in this case, it's wpbeginner.xyz, which is a dummy URL, /category/cat-1, which is the name of the category itself. And this is all the posts in that specific category. And you already done what you were trying to do, right? Already created a blog feed for just the category one. And whatever category you want to have a blog feed, just click open it in a new tab, and you have now have the URL of that specific category's blog feed. And now you can copy this URL and you can just paste it anywhere. You want to create a menu entry, footer entry, highlight in some of the blog posts, create a button, anything, add it to the footer or add it to the sidebar. Whatever you want to do, the URL will act as the direct path to reaching that specific blog post, which lists all the blog posts in that specific category. And there's one quick hack also I want to show you here, right here, which might make sense to you if you're just trying to customize everything. So if you go into the permalink settings of WordPress, right here, WordPress settings, permalinks, you can actually customize the category label right here. If you notice the URL right here, I'll put it on the screen as well. The URL is wpbeginner.xyz, which is the homepage or the actual URL of the website, /category. This is the category label. If you want to customize that, you can actually do it right here by or changing this option right here. So let's say instead of a category, I want to say or call it topic, right? I'll save my changes. And once the changes have been saved, I'll go back to the my categories. So post categories. And right here, I'll just try and open this up once again. This is the post that's open up, and I'll post the URL once again on the screen. And now the URL has actually changed to wpbeginner.xyz-topic-cat-1. And now instantly, your website's categories look much more dynamic, and you can you have complete control. So you can do anything you like right here. And the same thing you can apply to actually tags as well. It's not limited to categories. Let's say you use tags as the primary tags on your website. You can not only create tag URLs by going into tags right here instead of categories, you can also change the tag labels or just customize them by going to the permalinks right here. Similar to how I changed the category base, you can change the tag base as well. So that's one of the easiest ways to not only create a blog feed, but also create a blog feed specifically for a specific tag synonym on your site, whether it be categories or tags. But there's also another exciting scenario that will give you even more control over how you want to display your blog posts on your site rather than a certain category or all the blog posts. So let's talk about that method, which might be really, really powerful. So stay tuned. All right, let's talk about method number three to create a specific page for just a blog post on your website. Now, this method is not necessarily complex or difficult to implement, but it's actually much more customizable than the other two methods that I just showed you. And not only can you customize what is going to be displayed on the screen, that means what blog post, but also how they will show up, and you have some sort of control. So even if you're a beginner in WordPress, I would highly suggest that watch this because it's not difficult to set up and gives you more control. All right, so on the screen right here, what you can see is just a single page I have created on the site. It's a blank page, nothing done, nothing fancy, just a page that you'll also create with the blog editor. And what you'll do to add the list of blog posts on your site on this page specifically is add a special block on this page. And the block is called, actually, let's type /, and I'll type in posts, P-O-S-T-S, and you'll see this posts list block show up right here. We'll add this right here. And this is a special block that lists all the posts you have on your site. Now, don't just go by its name. It actually offers a lot more customization abilities compared to the first two methods. So what I'll do is instead of start blank, I'll choose a pattern for the query block. So what the pattern offers is to is gives you multiple ways on how you want to show all the blog posts on your site. So right now I have two options, which is a wider view and the second is a grid view. And what you can do is in the carousel view right here, you can actually choose from pre-built layouts that you can have or use to display the post on your site. So what you do is click on the arrow and you start seeing different ways how the blog post can be shown on your website. And you have a multiple options already pre-built for you. And right now the website is not designed. There's not much content here. So you might not, this might not look as beautiful as it might look on a well-designed website, but the idea is still here, right? You can see this is a beautiful column-based display you can use on a site. So let's choose this one. And it'll start showing up all the blog posts right here. And of course, we can customize a lot of the options. So once you've selected this block, right? Selected this block, you'll see the block options right here. And this is where the magic happens. You have a lot of different customization utilities that you can start using to customize how the blog post will look like. So inherit default layout, this means it will inherit the default layout of the theme. You can enable, disable this. And you can also specify the content pixels and content width. So you can customize how you want the content to be displayed. And you also have some other options right here. This is one of the powerful ones. Post type is set to post. Now, this is the method that is not available in any other methods that I talked about. Right now, what you can do is just change this to page. And instead of the post on your website, you can also start displaying pages on your website. This is a very powerful feature not available in the first two methods. Let's go back to post just for simplicity. And then you also have the option to customize the columns. So let's say I just like two columns, I can change it to, or if I like four columns, I can change it to four. All is options available right here. Then comes the more powerful options, order by newest to oldest. So you can customize this post or this blog feed to show or change the order from newest to oldest, oldest to newest, or alphabetical as well in descending or in ascending order. Again, this method or this customization is not available in the first two methods. Then also you have the option of including or excluding sticky posts, which is not available in the first two methods. Then comes the best part, right? Filters. Now, in the first two methods, what we showed, first method was all the blog posts, second method was specific taxonomies. But right now in the filters options right here, you get the best or most amount of control that you'll need to do anything on your site. So you have filters for categories, authors, and keywords. So you want to display posts from just one category? That's perfectly fine. So let's say if I type in cat one, only blogs from cat one will show. But if I want to also include posts from cat two, they also show up. Beautiful, right? And then you can also filter based on authors and also add certain keywords. That's so awesome, right? And of course, you have some basic design options as well. If you want to change the text color and the background color, you can do that right here. But the easy or interesting part is not only can you customize how it appears, you have multiple layout and column grids and carousel views and all those options available, you can also customize what content is being displayed. So you can really create customized pages on your site displaying just the right information that you want to show based on keywords, authors, or even categories. That's pretty powerful. And if you want to create just a specific page for this blog feed, right now we already are creating a page, you can also explore this option right here. And one more best part about this option or this method that we're using to display all the blog posts on a specific page is that this is still a regular page in WordPress and it's created with the block editor. So after this, I can actually still add more blocks. I can design the page, I can add more content here and have the content or whatever I want on this blog feed. So apart from the blog feed, I have still complete control over what content I want to display. And I can add the blog feed to the bottom of the post, the middle of the post, or page specifically, and just do anything I like with the blog page right here, or all the blog feed. So this method gives you the most amount of control over what you want to display, how you want to display it, and even add more content to the page that you're designing for your blog feed. So excellent method, method number three. But now there's one more thing that we need to cover before we end this video, and that is how do you do this if you're using a page builder, right? Now, right now we're using the block editor, but how do we do this with a page builder? So let me talk about that after this transition. All right, let's talk about method number four to create a separate page on your site just to display the blog post on your website. And as I mentioned, I'll be using page builders in this example. And the reason to use page builders, why would you want to use this? Because page builders give you a lot more control over the design. Drag and drop, intuitive controls right here, no code required, and a lot more control over the pages and design on your website. Now, all the page builders are probably almost all the page builders on the market will be able to do what I'm going to demonstrate right now, but I'm going to be using a page builder called SeedProd, because SeedProd is one of the best page builders out there according to me, and I already have it installed and activated on my website. And as I said, the same methodology that I'm showing in SeedProd can be done with other page builders as well. And SeedProd has a lot of features. Let's talk about that. So I'll be using a feature inside SeedProd called Theme Builder. Now, Theme Builder, what it does is let you design a complete theme for your website. Now, if you're starting out, your website hasn't been designed yet, this is a great feature to use, but you don't have to use this feature to create or customize the blog feed on your site. I'll be demonstrating how to do that, but since my website is not completely made, as you saw, the design wasn't perfect, the theme build allows me to also have a great design on my website, right? So what I will be doing is going to the add new theme template right here, or even the themes right here, and this will show me all the themes that are available for me to choose to write directly import on my website. And all of them look beautiful. You can pick anyone, or I'll just pick this one right now. I'll click this and it'll import all the pages on my website that has or that are included with this specific theme template. It'll create the home page, the index page, and all that page. Let's wait for a few seconds for this to complete, and I'll then demonstrate how we can start customizing some of these options or abilities. So right now you can see all the pages have been imported on my website, right? So the page that I'm interested in is the blog feed page. And from the just for the name, you can see the blog page is the page that will have a feed of the blog post, right? So what I'll do is open this up in Seedprod's editor. So by doing this or clicking this button right here, which says edit design, I'll open this up in a new tab. And this will open up the Seedprod builder or Seedprod builder right here. And as you can see, if you scroll down right here, this has already included a feed of all the blog posts on the site. Now, if you are not familiar with page builders, let me just give you a crash course on how it works. On the right side, which I'll highlight on the screen, you have the actual design of your page. And on the left side, you have content in forms of blocks that you can add on the page. So this is a block, this is a block, and this is also a block. And you can add tons of blocks right here. For example, you see template blocks available, you have standard blocks, you have advanced blocks, you have all those blocks. So whatever content you want to customize or even add to the page, just drag and drop it right here, and the block will be added in whatever place you like. So it's a drag and drop functionality. So if I click this one, as you see, this is highlighted as a block. If I click this, the options for that will open up. So what this is a posts block, which lists all the posts on your website. Now, this part is important to understand. This is very similar to how I achieved this in method number 3, where I included a query block on the page, but I was using the block editor inside WordPress. Right now, I'm doing something similar. I'm using a post block, but I'm using it in Seedprod. And of course, you can do this with any other page builder. You'll have similar functionality in other page builders as well. Now, the best part, one more thing to understand is that you don't have to use this block just because it's added on the page. Let's say you just design a new page with Seedprod. So you can just add the post block on the page and you can have all the functionality just exactly like this. And you don't need to use the theme that's been included with Seedprod if you already have a beautiful looking theme out there, right? Just clarifying out there. I'm just using this because I didn't have a great design on my website anyway. So right now you have all the options again for the post block right here. So query type is default, custom, and manual. So default query is just a regular feed. I'll also demonstrate what other options you have. You can change customization. You have include pagination. You can enable or disable featured images. So featured image disabled, enabled, title enabled. Oops, where did it go? Title enabled. Show meta, title tag, what heading block would you, or what heading would you like it to use for the title block? H4, H3, H1, that's up to you. Show metadata, you can include it. So metadata will start showing up. I don't like it usually, so I'll disable this. And with the metadata, you had options to customize it as well. You have a bunch of other options. And if I change this to, let's say, custom, you can actually customize all those options. So post types, do you want to include posts or include posts, media, or pages? You have that option right here. Query by category. This is again the same feature. If you enable this, you can select only certain categories that you want to display in this blog feed. And a query by tags and authors is the same thing as I demonstrated, but I'll just disable it right now. Let's enable this and explore some other options. Well, order by also right here. You can have comment counts, how many comments of popular posts can show up first, menu order, title, everything. Order ascending, descending. All these options are now available to you to customize this blog feed however you like. And the third option is also very exciting. It's a manual thing. And what you can do is just use this query parameters changes to display only certain, or I say manually selected posts on a site. So right now, if you just dissect this, it says post type is post. That means the post will display post per page is 3. That means only 3 pages. And you can also just say, okay, descending order, post publish. So the idea here is that even if you, let's say you are familiar with query parameters, you have that control right here built in inside Seedprod that you can utilize. But I say most people will be happy with the custom one or the default one. And as I mentioned, you don't need to use this specific blog post. You can open up any page right here. Let's say you want to create a new post on your site, create a new page or post, and then add that post block on the page right there, and then customize all these options once again. And you don't even have to use the theme builder. You can actually use this or with your existing theme as well, right? So all the customization beautiful options are built right inside this beautiful page builder Seedprod. And I'll leave a link down in the description to Seedprod's website if you want to check it out. And of course, all the methods that I demonstrated will work exactly the same way as I demonstrated. So let me know in the comments which of these methods you found the most helpful. And if you have any questions about this, also leave that in the comments. If you have feedback for this lesson, you can leave that in the comments as well. Before you go, check out some of these videos right here. And also subscribe to our channel if you're interested in easy to use, easy to follow WordPress tutorials. I'll catch you in the next video. Take care.